taxi dispatchers, union halls to do that. And when we saw Wireless Philadelphia on its last legs, we pushed for community voices to be heard about the need for affordable internet. Also, when the opportunity arose for federal investment that was going to create the Philly Key Spots program, we were there talking to partners around the country on how Philadelphia could be a leader in that project. And now today, we see that the city is still faced with the question of what are we going to do to get the 36% of Philadelphians at least online, on the internet, and to have their access to their human right of communication. And I think the type of solutions that were discussed today are exactly the things that Comcast should be jumping at as the opportunities to really make sure that every person in the city could get online. And so that means investing in a significant and ongoing way in our schools to make sure that every child has a librarian and access to the technology tools that they need. That means expanding the Internet Essentials program so that every low-income person in the city will qualify without a requirement of turning off their service for 90 days. That means that Philly Cam and all of the city's public access have the support that they need. And that means establishing a digital inclusion fund that really has community stakeholders decide what happens in investment.
Thank you. So
just the very quickly last point. In May 2015, the New York Times reported that Comcast's revenue for internet service for the first time surpassed their revenue for cable service. And so that means that this franchise agreement is fundamentally different from the last
agreement.